Perhaps you've heard me talk in the past about VR technologies and immersive experiences for treatment of illness and also for changing homeostasis, regulating our biology. VR and extended technologies, including immersive experiences, are being applied right now to healthcare to treat various conditions, including burns, eating disorders, autism, and inflammation. So here are some examples. VR serves as a non-pharmacological pain management tool for burn patients, particularly during dressing changes and wound care. Immersive VR environments help distract patients, reducing pain perception by 30% to 50% in many cases. Active VR games, and by the way, we are producing a VR game, I am producing a VR game for children for attention deficit disorder, but just to bring presence into every moment of the experience. I'm introducing that. Stay tuned for that. But active VR games have been proven effective more than even VR or standard care in pediatric burn pain management. VR exposure therapy has also helped patients confront triggers on controlled environments such as virtual grocery stores or calming settings. It aids in reducing symptoms of anorexia and bulimia by promoting healthy coping mechanisms and addressing body image and distortions. Technologies like VR exposure and multisensory body illusions enhance traditional cognitive behavioral therapy, known as CBT, improving outcomes for binge eating and bulimia nervosa. VR is also used in applied behavior analysis therapy to teach social communication and life skills in structured virtual environments. This reduces anxiety and sensory overload while enhancing learning outcomes for children with autism. Tailored VR experiences also allow clinicians to adjust complexity, ensuring individualized support. Inflammation and pain. By reducing stress and pain perception, VR indirectly mitigates inflammation linked to chronic pain conditions. Its biofeedback mechanisms enable real-time monitoring and adjustment of therapy for personalized care. VR's adaptability, immersive nature, and ability to simulate real-world scenarios, although I believe the real world is also a simulation, make it a transformative tool across these conditions. I'm particularly impressed by what's happening in autism therapy, where VR is being used for enhancing social communication and life skills for individuals with autism spectrum disorder, otherwise known as ASD. So VR creates immersive environments where children with autism spectrum disorder can practice social interactions such as making eye contact, interpreting social cues, and engaging in conversations. These scenarios are safe, controlled, and repeatable, reducing anxiety overload associated with so-called real-world situations. Studies show that VR-based interventions improve cognitive, social, and emotional skills. For example, participants retain learned skills even after the VR sessions end, demonstrating long-term benefits. Applied behavior analysis, ABA therapy. VR enhances ABA therapy by simulating real-world scenarios like school lunchrooms or busy streets, which are difficult to recreate in clinical settings. This allows therapists to teach safety and communication skills effectively. Tailored VR experiences can adjust complexity and sensory stimuli to suit individual needs, ensuring personalized care. Children participating in VR therapy often report high levels of enjoyment, This positive engagement leads to better learning outcomes as they are more motivated to participate and retain skills. There are platforms like Florio, XR Health, which offer VR-based therapy that can be accessed from home through telehealth kits. This removes barriers like travel and ensures therapy is accessible to individuals with varying levels of experience with technology. VR's ability to replicate so-called real-world scenarios, I have to remind you that real world is also a simulation. That's why the VR works on your body, which is part of the simulation. VR's ability to control these makes it an innovative complement to treat traditional autism therapies. So if you want to know more, check out deepakchopra.ai, cyberhuman.ai, or do your own research. Thank you, and happy trails wherever you go.